Welcome back to All the Hip Hop, where we don't listen to no trap, no whack raps, just straight hip hop. Now, if you guys are new to my channel, make sure you guys do subscribe. Also, I do got a fucking Patreon, just in case if you guys want to become members, have early access to my videos, all my content, as well as all my videos I cannot post on YouTube, man. And without further ado, we're just going to get started. So today, we got a brand new Skylar Grey song. It's called The Last One Standing, man. And basically, it's the soundtrack off of the Venom Let There Be Carnage movie part 2. Well, not part 2 of that movie, just part 2 of the Venom movie. And it has features from fucking Polo G, Mossy, and Eminem, man. Like, I don't know how to fucking feel about that, you know what I mean? It's fucking rare and fucking weird as fuck to me. I don't know about you guys, man. But, like, it's weird seeing Eminem collab with, you know, Mossy and Polo G and shit like that. But I guess now, like, nowadays, he's doing that more often, you know what I mean? With the whole new generation and shit like that. It's pretty dope, you know what I mean? I'm not hating and shit like that. I'm just saying, you know, it's fucking weird as fuck. But hopefully it fits in good and sounds good. We're about to check this shit out and see if it does, you know what I mean? Let's get started.
Now you see me standing in the lights, but you never saw my sacrifice.
Now you see me standing in the light, but you never saw my sacrifice, man.
Or all the nights I had to struggle to survive.
All the mess I had to struggle to survive. If that's not, you know what I mean, the most fucking relatable shit I done heard in the fucking while, man. I don't know what the fuck to tell you, man.
Had to lose it all to win the fight. I had to fall so many times. Oh, now I'm the last one standing.
You want with me on the cold block nights. Now you front row for the spotlight. Now the diamonds in the Audemars bright. Just overseas.
I was not ready for fucking.
You want with me on the cold block nights. Now you.
You weren't with me on them cold block nights, man.
Front row for the spotlight.
Now you front row for them spotlights or for the spotlight.
Diamonds in the Audemars bright.
Man, hold up. Like, dude, I fucking hate that shit. I don't know why motherfuckers have that fucking mindset. You know what I mean? Like, if you're fucking struggling to make it, or fucking, you know, struggling to, you know, build your own fucking goal, or reach your goal, I mean, and basically, you know, when you're in that fucking position that you're trying to be someone in life, you know, where whether it is fucking YouTube, rapping, or getting into fucking, you know, TV shows, acting, and all that type of shit, you know what I mean, like, the road to fame and shit like that, basically, you're gonna lose a lot of motherfuckers, a lot of fucking friends, a lot of relationships, man, and basically, when you're out there, that's when all these motherfuckers start coming back, man. If I fucking see that shit personally with me, man, I'm gonna sock the fucking dog shit out of you, man. Like, motherfucker, like, makes no fucking sense. Like, why the fuck, you know what I mean? I'm gonna lose you in the process, and then for some fucking reason out of thin air, you just come back like I owe you something, or you were there struggling with me, and you came up there struggling with me, man. I'm like, fuck out of here, bitch. The fuck? Let's go back to it, man.
Just overseas for a fight flight. Young nigga on bullshit and I ball on them Bill Cartwright.
Knew I could shine through the darkness.
I guess I always been a star type. That line in me made my heart fight. Bullshit and I ball on them Bill Cartwright.
Knew I could shine through the darkness.
I guess I always
shine through the darkness.
Always been a star type.
I guess I always been a star type, man.
That line in me made my heart fight. Could have been a victim of a op pipe. Took a million risks just to get to this. Cause we ain't the ones that the cops like. Been so many times God tested me. They only see the answers I got right. They commenting all on the blogs trying to tell me how to live my life.
And I waited so patiently. If you could take off, don't wait for me. No days off, grind faithfully. I keep thinking,
man. Tell me how to live my life. And I waited so patiently. If you could take off, don't wait for me. No days off, grind faithfully. I keep thanking God for saving me. Frontline showcasing our bravery. I know that top spot, it was made for me. It all paid off, so we felt the struggle so painfully.
Now you see me standing in the lights, but you never saw my sacrifice. Or all the nights I had to struggle to survive. Had to lose it all to win the fight. I had to fall so many times.
See, that's what I like about Skylar Grey, man. Like, her voice is not too over fucking powering. It's not too fucking, you know what I mean, aggressive. And it just gives you a good ass fucking vibe, you know what I mean? Like, on the fucking, what the fuck was that album called that she did with fucking M? Music to Be Murdered By, the song, what the fuck, Heaven Some Shit, or what, I forgot what the fuck it was called, man. But her voice with that, it fucking gave me chills, dude. Like, there's not a lot of fucking female, you know what I mean, singers that can do that or pull that shit off, you know. We got fucking Faith Evans. We got Mary J. Blige, man. We We had a fucking Aaliyah, man. We have who else do we got? We got a couple. I know I'm forgetting a lot, man, or a couple of them, you know what I mean? But there's so many, or not so many of them that can actually, you know what I mean, give you chills and fucking, you know, make it sound right on a track, man, and have that voice that's not too overpowering. Like with motherfucking vocals, I know I talked about that in the whole fucking DMX Exodus album reaction review thing, where he had Bono, and his voice was not too overpowering, you know what I mean? It was just right. It kind of give you that good-ass vibe, you know what I mean? Smooth and shit like that. He had a good-ass tone for that. But yeah, other than that, man, like, all these fucking other artists, they be getting some, like, fucking male or fucking, you know, female singer, and their fucking voice be fucking weird as fuck, man. Like, it's too aggressive, and it just fucking overpowers the beat and shit like that. Be like, what the fuck, man? But let's go back, man. It's getting off fucking.
Last one standing.
Yeah, you know the code, we gotta live by it. Never mind all the ice cubes on his wrist wearing the big body. Live by the gun, get body during cellar time in that cell. It was hella times where I fell when I had to double back from them L's. Bet he don't double back when he tell. Cause it ain't no coming back when you tell. Why would you leave me here by myself? A nigga be lonely. Hey, I blew the whole bag on they flights, ain't leaving our homies. If he really gained and get him a chain, no Cubans to call me. White Zime in the stogie, stood firm, never folded. Furthest thing from a rotor, you put the jacket on and you bogus. Yeah, big dog and they know it, I had to spin off to stay focused. Long jab on emotion, we on the bandit ship when it's hopeless. I'd have been broken for and they know it.
Let me step right there, man. Let me say, you know, having M on the track, I know we didn't get to his part, but just having M on the track, you can tell, you know, Mossy and Polo G fucking came with it. And it brought the fucking best out of them, man. Now, I know I don't fucking listen to a lot of Polo G or Mossy, you know what I mean? I done heard, like, what, one or two or three songs from them and shit like that. But for my fucking, you know what I mean, or for what I can fucking tell, is that being on this track with them, they had to fucking come with it and fucking be prepared and fucking, you know, bring the best fucking versions of themselves on this track, man. Now, I don't know if you guys fucking agree or disagree with me, man. Comment down below.
Like I made it overnight, I make it look easy. But you don't see the dark side and all of the monsters I defy.
No fucking hell, it's gonna have like 2 minutes on the show.
Y'all say, what? I've changed, what? Really don't, tell me how so, I got all what? This bread, yeah. I'm still what? Sour though, I don't know, I'm squid pig, hold up, yeah. Round hole, yeah. I've changed, what? Really don't. Y'all say, what? I've changed, what? Really don't, tell me how so,
I got no change, I stayed, man. And that kind of reminds me of that song, How Come, you know what I mean, I changed. You got a phone call me or some shit like that. I forgot what the fuck it was, but it reminds me of that little part, man.
Yeah. Y'all say, what? I've changed. What? Really don't. Tell me how so. I got all what? This bread. Yeah. I'm still what? Sour though. Mm. I don't know. I'm a squid pig. In a round hole. Like a block of cheese in a paper towel roll. Rocky Balboa. Never been no what? Towel thrower. Even when I got kicked to the curb. Yeah. Life knocked my dick in the dirt. I got back up, flipped at the bird. Till I earned the attention I yearn. Not to mention I learned how to turn resentment and hurt to an unquenchable thirst. In the simplest terms, it's revenge of the nerd in every sense of the word. But all you see is the fame and the millions.
Let's go back a little bit, man.
I yearn not to mention I learned how to turn resentment and hurt to an unquenchable thirst. In the simplest terms, it's revenge of the nerd in every sense of the word. But all you see is the fame and the millions. You don't see the strength and resilience. How I rack my brain, but it feels as if I'm trying to explain it to children. So a lot of this pain isn't healing. You're escaping if this anger is spilling. Almost like recreating the feeling of 9/11 when the second plane hit the building. So let them paint me the villain. Some of this just may be a symptom of having way too much income. But when you struggle every day just to get some, now all of this hate is a syndrome. When they can't relate, that stems from money looking like it grows on trees. Get a green, but those aren't leaves. Suffice to say, with every sacrifice, I'm saying it was spilling. Almost like recreating the feeling of 9/11 when the second plane hit the building. So let them paint me the villain. Some of this just may be a symptom of having way too much income. But when you struggle every day just to get some, now all of this hate is a syndrome. When they can't relate, that stems from money looking like it grows on trees. Get a green, but those aren't leaves. Suffice to say, with every sacrifice I made, it's like I gave up my life to fame. All the nights that I lied awake, nights I stayed up to write and pray.
If you know fucking M's story, then you know this man, you know what I mean, never had a DC. As well as other artists, you know what I mean? And he fucking really struggled like that, man, just to be fucking, you know what I mean, famous and get to a position in life where you can fucking provide for Haley and his family and shake that, man. Like, it's fucking, it was tough as fuck, man. It was fucking hard as fuck, man.
Claw scratch and fight my way. Just follow me and I like the way. Look to the hook if your sky look gray. Skyland rappers, how can we be on the same aren't leaves? Suffice to say, with every sacrifice I made, it's like I gave up my life to fame. All the nights that I lied awake, nights I stayed up to write and pray. Had to claw scratch and fight my way. Just follow me.
And this shit right here, man, just had me thinking, you know what I mean? There's a lot of fucking artists that once when they do become famous, man, they realize that fame has a fucking dark side and fame is not what, you know what I mean, all these fucking other artists made it out to be, man. Like, if you fucking, you know what I mean? Like, if you're a fucking artist and whatnot and you blow up and you actually get to where you want to be, like, fame-wise, you know what I mean? You're going to fucking see that shit for yourself. Like, the music industry and fame has a whole fucking different dark side that these fucking artists do not tell you about, man. Some of them do, some of them don't, man, but it's the truth, man. I don't know if you guys agree or disagree with me on that, man.
And I like the way, look to the hook if your sky look gray. Skyland rappers, how can we be on the same level now when I gotta look down and see these clowns that are on the ground? Bitch, I got the clouds beneath
oh,
me
fuck, since I put up, out the what the fuck?
Leaves. Suffice to say, out, with
man.
Every sacrifice I made, it's like I gave up my life to fame. All the nights that I lied awake, nights I stayed up to write and pray. Had to claw, scratch, and fight my way. Just follow me, and I like the way. Look to the hook if your sky look gray. Skyland rappers, how can we be on the same level now when I got.
And rappers, how the. You know, we can be on the same level.
I look down and see these clowns that are on the ground, bitch. I look great. Skyland rappers, how can we be on the same level now when I got a.
Rappers, how can we be on the same level now?
Look down and see these.
I gotta look down and
clowns that are on the ground, bitch. I got clouds beneath me.
These clowns? Oh, man. Fuck, man. He's calling you guys out. You know what I mean? He, like, that's the thing about Ev, man. Every time he fucking gets on the track, he like gives no fuck. He still wants all the fucking smoke. He calls you motherfuckers out, man. It's fucking
rappers, how can we be on the same level now when I gotta look down to see these clowns that are on the ground? Bitch, I got clouds beneath me. Ever since I put out the EP to the height of 2003, me, you ain't see the struggle to make it out the D because I made it somehow.
Let's go back.
Clouds beneath me. Ever since I put out the EP to the height of 2003.
Every time, what the fuck was it? Hold up.
How can we be on the same level now when I gotta look down to see these clowns that are on the ground? Bitch, I got clouds beneath me. Ever since I put out.
Ever since I put out.
The EP to the height of 2000.
The EP for the hype of the
2003. Me, you ain't see the struggle to make it out the DB. Of 2003. Me, you ain't see the struggle to make it out the DB because I made it somehow look easy.
Now you see me.
In facts, man. Like, if you're born, you know what I mean? In the fucking mid-90s era in 2000s, that you know motherfucking Eminem was taking over the fucking game, man. Like, there was no fucking artist like this dude, you know what I mean? And now when he came out with fucking, you know what I mean, D12 and fucking 50, that was a whole fucking game changer. And fucking 50 brought G-Unit, you know, Young Buck, Lloyd Banks, who was the other dude? I know he had Lloyd Banks, fucking Young Buck, and Tony Yayo and shit like that. When that fucking era hit in the 2000s, man, that was a whole fucking game changer. Like, there was no one doing it like them, you know what I mean? It was a whole fucking thing you guys had to witness and see with your own eyes, man. It was a crazy ass era, and I'm fucking glad I was born and brought up in that era, man. So what's the 90s, you know what I mean?
Standing in the lights, but you never saw my sacrifice.
Never saw my sacrifice.
All the nights I had to struggle to survive.
This shit got me doing the fucking ad-libs.
Had to lose it all to win the fight. I had to fall so many times. Oh,
I like the way she
now
fucking
I'm
sings.
The last one standing. Oh, now I'm the last one standing.
Right, so that was Last One Standing featuring Polo G, Mossy and Eminem, Skylar Grey, man, for the Venom soundtrack to Venom, Let There Be Carnage, man. What do you guys think about that? Was it ass or was it fucking fire, man? Do you guys give it a pass? For me personally, I'm gonna rate it a 9 out of 10, you know what I mean? I'm a fucking diehard Eminem fan, so what's a DMX fan, man? And yeah, for me to see this, you know what I mean? I know I don't react to Eminem a lot, because a lot of fucking reaction channels already do, so I don't see the point in that, you know what I mean? But yeah, with this fucking feature, it was weird at first, but it just fucking fit perfectly, you know what I mean? Like I said, M brought the best out of Mossy and fucking Polo G on this track, man. And I don't know if you guys agree or disagree with me, or fucking disagree. I fucked up there, man. What I was fucking saying is that Eminem, you know, made Mossy and Polo G bring out the best fucking versions of themselves on this track and fucking made them fucking, you know what I mean, push themselves harder to bring in their A game and shit like that and come harder with it, you know what I mean? So I don't know if you guys fucking agree or disagree with me on this shit, man. Comment down below. But that was the end of the fucking reaction video. So hopefully you guys like it, and see you guys in the next one, man.